Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to see how to install a macOS virtual machine on a Linux computer. Let's start by opening the project's GitHub page. I'll add a link to the description below. And from here, we're going to choose the green button, which is code, and download zip. And let's save the file. It was downloaded to the downloads folder, and we can see it here. Next thing is opening a terminal, so let's open a terminal. And let's change directory to the downloads folder. And when listing the files, you can see macos-simple-kvm master, which is the file we just downloaded. Let's extract the zip archive. I'm going to choose extract here. And it created a new folder, so let's move into this new folder in the terminal. And let's list the files again. One of the files is readme. So let's open this readme file. Okay, getting started. So it tells us that we need a Linux machine and we'll need QEmu, Python 3 and pip. Luckily, it's telling us how to install these requirements for different distributions of Linux. And since I'm using Ubuntu, I'll choose the first one. But before running it, I'm going to update my system to make sure that I'm up to date. Great, and now let's copy the line from the instructions and run it. Okay, I already have everything in its newest version, so I didn't have to download anything new, but in your case it might take a while. Anyway, once it's done, we can move on to step one. So we need to run jumpstart.sh to download the installation media for macOS. And it's actually going to access the Apple servers and download the operating system for us. So let's run the file. Okay, and it's downloading the operating system from Apple servers. Great, it's done. And it's telling us that we now have a file called basesystem.img. Let's ls again. And we can see it here, basesystem.img. Let's move on to step two. Create an empty hard disk using QEmu img. So let's do that. And we can change the name of the disk. The default is mydisk.qcow2. And 64 gigabytes is a bit too much for me, so I'm going to go with 35 gigabytes. Let's take a look at the files now. And here is basesystem.img, and here is the disk, mydisk.qcow2. We now need to add the information about this new virtual disk to the basic.sh file. So let's open the file, basic.sh. And let's copy these two lines and paste them. Okay, we now need to run basic.sh. So let's do that. We can close it from here. And it's starting the virtual machine. Notice that once I click inside the box of the virtual machine, I cannot control the mouse anymore. It's like closed inside the virtual machine. To release it, we need to click Ctrl+Alt+G, which is written at the title of the virtual machine window. So Ctrl+Alt+G, and I regain control of my mouse. Anyway, back in the virtual machine, I need to press Enter to boot macOS from the macOS base system. So let's do that, Enter. And let's take another look at the instructions file. We told that we need to run the disk utility first. So let's do that. I'm going to run disk utility, as I was told. On the left-hand side, we can see a list of virtual disks. And there are three disks here. One is macOS base system, and its size is about 2 gigabytes. The one above it is QEmu hard disk media, and it's about 260 megabytes. And the first one is uninitialized, and its size is about the size that we allocated. If you remember, I allocated 35 gigabytes, and here I see about 37. Anyway, that's the one that we want to initialize. It's currently not initialized, and that's where macOS will reside. So let's initialize this virtual hard drive by clicking on erase. Let's give it a name. I'm just going to call it main disk. As for the format, I'm going to choose APFS, which is short for Apple File System, and that's the modern and recommended file system for macOS machines. Now let's click on erase. And it's done. And now in the list, we can see main disk, which is the one we just initialized. And we can see that it's an APFS volume, and the name is the name we gave it. Let's close the disk utility. And now I'm going to choose reinstall macOS. Let's select our main disk and install. macOS is now being installed on the virtual hard disk. It's going to take a while, so I'll be back when it's done. Okay, we're back. The installation is almost done. Let's select our location. I'm going to go with USA, even though I'm not really from the USA. We can transfer information. I'm not going to transfer anything. We can sign in with an Apple ID. Not going to do that. Enter your name, your account name, and your password. And then go with the express setup. We need to help the system to identify our keyboard layout. So let's click on continue. And now we need to press on the key immediately to the right of the shift key on the left side of the keyboard. So let's do that. And let's confirm its conclusion. And we have macOS up and running. One thing that might bother you is the low resolution, because right now it's not using the entire screen. So let's see how we can fix it so it will use the entire screen. But first I'm going to ask it to ignore these updates for now. Okay, let's release the mouse with Ctrl-Alt-G again, and let's get back to the installation folder. There is a folder here called docs. Let's get into it. And one of the files here is guide screen resolution. Let's open it. First, we need to open Finder and look for EFI. Currently, we don't see EFI on the list, so we'll have to add it. So here are the instructions to mount the folder of the EFI. We need to open the terminal and type diskutil list. There are two entries called EFI. One is in the main disk, the big one, the one we allocated ourselves. And the second one is in a small disk, the one that was created automatically. The one we are interested in is the one in the small disk, so inside disk one. Let's get back to the instructions. And we need to run sudo diskutil mount and then the name of the disk. So let's try and do that. Oh, sorry, my mistake. I need to use the name over here, the identifier. So let's try again and use the identifier. So the identifier of the disk is disk1 S1. And it was mounted. And now when we get back to the Finder, we can see it on the list. Let's get back to the instructions. And we should have a folder inside it called Clover, and inside it a file called config.plist. Let's look for it. And here is config.plist. Let's edit the file. I'm going to use text edit for that. And here we can see the resolution it's currently using, so I'm going to change it to the resolution of my screen. And let's save the file and exit. We now need to shut down the VM, then relaunch it using basic.sh script, and then we need to do the following. Press escape as soon as the window comes up, and in the interface that comes up, select Device Manager, OVMF Platform Configuration, Change Preferred, and select the correct resolution. So let's do that. Let's get back to the terminal. Let's run basic.sh again. And as soon as the machine will boot up, I'm going to quickly press the escape key. Okay, we got to the menu. And here I'm going to choose Device Manager and OVMF Platform Configuration. And let's change the resolution. Let's save it by pressing F10. Now let's exit. We now need to choose the media to boot up from, and I'm going to choose main disk because that's where macOS is installed. And it's now using high definition resolution. Let's log in. Let's switch to full screen. Let's release the mouse again using Ctrl-Alt-G. And under View, we can see that the shortcut for full screen is Ctrl-Alt-F. So let's try it. And it's now using the entire screen. I want to show one last thing. Let's exit full screen by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F again, then Ctrl-Alt-G to release the mouse. And let's take another look at basic.sh. From here, we can change the amount of RAM we allocate to the virtual machine and how many processor cores we allocate. As can be seen, the default is 2 GB of RAM and 2 physical cores. Let's increase it, so our virtual machine will perform better. Let's shut down the virtual machine. I'm going to change the 2 GB of RAM to 5, so the virtual machine will have 5 GB. And because it's using 2 virtual cores for every physical core, I'm going to change the 4 to 8 and 2 to 4. Which means that 4 physical cores will be allocated to the virtual machine. Let's save the file. And now let's run the virtual machine again. And let's take a look at the activity monitor. And under memory, we can see that we now have 5 GB of RAM. That would be all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.